What's good, YouTube? It's your boy, Blue Blood Sports TV, back at y'all with another one. So, legendary 8th Division World Champion, Filipino, iconic superstar boxer, who is currently the WBA Welterweight World Champion, Manny Pac-Man Pacquiao. He says he would indeed face off against undefeated 3 Division World Champion, former junior welterweight undisputed world champion, currently the WBO welterweight world champion, who is widely considered the number one pound-for-pound fighter in the world, Terrence Bud Crawford. But in doing so, his former promoter, who is Terrence Crawford's current promoter, iconic top-ranked CEO Bob Arum, has to guarantee and show proof of funds of at least $20 million to stage the fight. So Manny Pacquiao is letting Bob Arum know that Terrence Crawford is not out the picture completely. But if Bob Arum could find investors to come up with the $20 million guaranteed number that Manny Pacquiao is looking for a fight with Terrence Crawford, then he'll gladly accept facing off against Terrence Bud Crawford. But he states that, but first, he's going to have to guarantee us and show us proof of funds that we're going to get the $20 million that we're looking for. So essentially, Manny Pacquiao's stance has yet to change on his views and the fight with Terrence Crawford. He's standing on the square. We're in year seven. This has been being talked about since the year 2014. If you want to be realistic, 2015. Bob Arum had Manny Pacquiao still signed to Top Rank, had Terrence Crawford signed to Top Rank, and Bob Arum essentially stated that he prevented the fight from happening because Manny Pacquiao he viewed as a friend. Manny Pacquiao was getting older, and he didn't want to see Manny Pacquiao possibly get hurt against Terrence Crawford. And then another sticking point was that he didn't want to pay $20 million to Manny Pacquiao to face Terrence Crawford because essentially he just didn't see the value in it. He didn't see the value in Terrence Crawford, and he didn't see the value in Manny Pacquiao. He even went as far as to say when Manny Pacquiao exited Top Rank and himself signed with PBC, Premier Boxing Champions, founder and advisor Al Haymon, that when he fought Adrian Broner, 4 division world champion on pay-per-view, it did 400,000 pay-per-view buys, and Manny Pacquiao got $20 to $25 million. And Bob Arum stated that he was just happy he wasn't liable to pay Manny Pacquiao that $20 to $25 million for a pay-per-view event that wasn't successful. Then Bob Arum went on to say that he knows that Keith Thurman fight with former unified WBC, WBA, welterweight world champion, superstar boxer. When he fought Manny Pacquiao got the same number. And again, he was happy that that fight didn't do as much that it should have, or it was being reported. It was being reported to do 500,000 pay-per-view buys. And he says that once again, he was just ecstatic that he didn't have to pay Manny Pacquiao that $20 to $25 million. Now you put two and two together. Bob Arum just recently stated that he's not profiting off of Terrence Crawford. He stated that his last three fights prior to Terrence Crawford fighting Kell Brook, he's lost so much money on Terrence Crawford that he could build a mansion in Beverly Hills from scratch. So that lets you know he doesn't value Terrence Crawford, and he don't think that Terrence Crawford can bring in enough revenue for him to fit the bill to pay Manny Pacquiao $20 million. All you have to do is add everything up. He believes that Terrence Crawford is going to be, and he says that Adrian Broner brings a lot of revenue. So if Manny Pacquiao fought Adrian Broner and it did 400,000 pay-per-views, and he doesn't value Terrence Crawford, and he didn't think that it was worth paying Manny Pacquiao $20 million for the Broner fight, then why would he think it's worth paying Manny Pacquiao $20 million for a Terrence Crawford fight? He wouldn't, because he don't think that either is worth it. So he won't sign off for it. And like he said, when you sign the Top Rank, he has the last say-so. his John Hancock has to go on that contract to yay or nay it. And he's not going to do so. So Bob Arum, he stated that he was informed that Pacquiao still is interested, but they still have that same number they were looking for the past 6 years, since 2015. We are now in 2021. And Manny Pacquiao stands on the $20 million that he was looking for when he was signed to Top Rank to fight Terrence Crawford. Well, he's still looking for that same number now, as I told you guys. And when Bob Arum stated that they had a deal in place, an agreement for Terrence Crawford to face off against Manny Pacquiao November 14th, I told you guys that wasn't real. That was indeed Bob Arum just trying to satisfy Terrence Crawford because he's not able to secure these big fights. And Terrence Crawford's lawyer came out and stated that they contacted Bob Arum, Todd DeBuff, and let them know that they're not happy with not securing a huge legacy, big lucrative money fight. So Bob Arum is reported to have an agreement with Terrence Crawford that if he can't secure these big fights on the back end for the fights he does have, he gets an extra $1 million because he wants to secure these big fights, that being Crawford. And if Bob can't deliver, then he offers him an extra $1 million on the back end. So Terrence Crawford's lawyer let it be known that their relationship is strained and they were looking forward to being a free agent in October of 2021. So with that said, that lets you know that they're not happy with the position they are in. But Bob Arum is not willing to overpay for these fights. And why would Bob Arum have a deal in place for Terrence Crawford to face Manny Pacquiao? But Manny Pacquiao, once again, Bob Arum has confirmed that Manny Pacquiao and his team were looking for the $20 to $25 million. And now you hear from Manny Pacquiao's team and say that's the number that they are indeed looking for if they're going to face Terrence Crawford. Otherwise, they have their sights set on facing UFC legend Conor McGregor. He has a fight coming up January 23rd. And then after that, they're looking to face off against undefeated unified WBC, IBF, welterweight world champion superstar boxer Earl "The Truth" Spence Jr., which they're not going to have an issue with doing business with and negotiating with because they're seemingly on the same side of the field. Now, Manny Pacquiao is currently a free agent, but he's going to still be advised by Al Haymon, and he won't have a problem doing business with Al Haymon for an Errol Spence fight in a unification bout. That would be huge. So this just lets you know that when Bob Arum said that Terrence Crawford had a deal in place to face Manny Pacquiao, he never had a deal in place. Bob Arum was looking for investors that would fit the bill for Manny Pacquiao's $20 million guaranteed and Terrence Crawford's purse. Bob Arum just recently stated that he didn't want to guarantee Keith Thurman or two-time welterweight world champion superstar boxer Showtime Sean Porter no more than $1 million guaranteed. Said, I'm not guaranteeing anything more than that. But they can get something on the back end. We could work out a deal for them to get something on the back end. So this just lets you know that Bob Arum never had a deal in place for Terrence Crawford to face Manny Pacquiao on November 14th. He needs an investment group that are willing to fit the bill solely for Manny Pacquiao, where Bob Arum doesn't lose at the end of the day, where he still wins. So they'll partially or fully fit the bill for Terrence Crawford, and then they'll fit the bill completely for Manny Pacquiao, and then he don't feel like he lost anything if it's not a success, if it doesn't do big. So there you have it, where Bob Arum stated that they were going to have that fight or looking to stage the fight outside of the country, but it fell through due to social distancing and investment groups and the venue not being able to guarantee that fans would be able to attend the live sporting event, and the closed circuit he would be losing. So there went the money that was supposed to go in the direction of Manny Pacquiao. Thus why you see Manny Pacquiao never even acknowledged, nor his team acknowledged, the fact that Bob Arum was saying they had a deal in place and Terrence Crawford was saying they had a deal in place for November 14th. That's why Manny Pacquiao never even acknowledged it, because they never got past the money. As I told you guys, Manny Pacquiao's stance had never changed. And now Manny Pacquiao's team has confirmed it. And now Bob Arum has confirmed that Manny Pacquiao's stance is still the same as it was from 2015, that he wants a guarantee of $20 million. And so with that said, Terrence Crawford, he came out and he stated that they had a deal in place. They had a date. They had a venue. They had the location. And then Terrence Crawford said everything was a go, but we almost, well, not quietly, but we nearly had the money for Manny Pacquiao. So that lets you know Manny Pacquiao never agreed to fight Terrence Crawford November 14th. If he's saying that he needs the guarantee and proof of funds up front before he even thinks about negotiating, that's the first order of business for Manny Pacquiao dealing with Bob Arum. So why would he agree to face Terrence Crawford November 14th and they have a verbal agreement or everything agreed upon except the money, when the first order of business for Manny Pacquiao, as you can see right out the gate, is for the money? That was never the case. That was simply a scenario where Bob Arum smoothed Terrence Crawford over, told him, oh, we have a deal in place for Manny Pacquiao. He agreed. Terrence Crawford didn't do his due diligence and look deeper into it. Bob Arum took it and run with it. Then Bob Arum told him, guess what? It fell through. The investors are no longer able to fit the bill. And Terrence Crawford went with it, said, okay, well, now we got to go with plan B. Plan B is going to be Kell Brook. Just see the writing on the wall. Manny Pacquiao had never agreed, nor would he agree until Bob Arum agrees to guarantee him $20 million. And if Bob Arum is not willing to pay Keith Thurman and Sean Porter a guaranteed of $1 million, what makes you believe, after Bob Arum stated that he was just happy he didn't have to fit the bill when Manny Pacquiao fought Keith Thurman and Adrian Broner for the $20 million because it wasn't successful, why would you think he's willing to fit the bill for Manny Pacquiao now? So we're going on, this is 6 years strong. Manny Pacquiao has been standing on his square. Bob Arum been standing on his square. And Terrence Crawford loses at the end of the day. So let's see how everything unfolds and plays out for Terrence Crawford moving forward. That's all I got for y'all. Make sure you hit the like button. Drop a comment in the comment section. Let me know what y'all think. Y'all already know what it is. It's your boy Blue, Blue Boy Sports TV. Hate, like, comment, and subscribe. If you haven't subscribed, hit the subscribe button. Hit the like button. Hit the bell icon to get all the new notifications. Follow me on Instagram at Blue Boy Sports TV, all one word. Y'all already know what it is. Shout out to the entire LDBC. Shout out to New Media. Shout out to Black Media World. Make sure you like and share these videos. That's all I got for y'all. Peace.